Welcome to today's concert, our 16th annual Carol Sing, a part of the 56th season of our St. Andrew Music Society's Music on Madison series. As with so many aspects of our lives in 2020, we're doing things a little differently this season. However, we're glad to be able to bring you wonderful performances directly from our sanctuary, broadcast to your electronic devices. If you didn't catch them, I invite you to look up the concerts that we offered during our fall Music on Madison series, to sign up for our music email list, or to make a contribution to the continuing work of the St. Andrew Music Society at the SAMS portion of our website, mapc.com. Normally, our Carol Sing involves a choir of over 100 singers and an audience that not only is packed into the rafters, but also joins us in singing some wonderful carols. I invite you to look for the link to our program so that you might join along. And finally, I look forward to the day when I'll be able to welcome you safely back into our sanctuary, hopefully next year, and I hope that you enjoy our virtual Carol Sing.
Thank you. So now is come our joyful feast, let everyone be jolly. Each room with ivy leaves is dressed, and every post with holly. Though some churls at our mirth repine, round your foreheads garlands twine, drown sorrow in a cup of wine, and let us all be merry. Now every lad is wondrous trim, and no man minds his labor. Our lasses have provided them a bagpipe and a tabor. Young men and maids and girls and boys give life to one another's joys, and you, anon, shall by their noise perceive that they are merry. Hark, how the wags abroad do call each other forth to rambling. Anon, you'll see them in the hall for nuts and apples scrambling. Hark, how the roofs with laughter sound. Anon, they'll think the house goes round, for they the cellar's depths have found, and there they will be merry. Then wherefore in these merry days should we, I pray, be duller? No, let us sing some roundelays to make our mirth the fuller. And whilst we thus inspired sing, let all the streets with echoes ring, woods and hills and everything bear witness. We are merry.
What sweeter music can we bring than a carol for to sing? The birth of this, our heavenly king? Awake the voice, awake the string. Heart, ear, and eye, and everything, awake, the while the active finger runs division with the singer. Dark and dull night, fly hence away, and give the honor to this day that sees December turn to May. If we may ask the reason, say, the why and wherefore all things here seem like the springtime for the year? Why does the chilling winter's morn smile like a field beset with corn, or smell like to a mead new shorn thus on the sudden? Come and see the cause why things thus fragrant be. 'Tis he is born whose quickening birth gives life and luster, public mirth to heaven and the under earth. We see him come and know him ours, who with his sunshine and his showers turns all the patient ground to flowers. The darling of the world is come, and fit it is we find a room to welcome him. The nobler part of all the house here is the heart, which we will give him and bequeath, this holly and this ivy wreath, to do him honor who's our king and lord of all this reveling.
Thank you.
As I sat at my windy one evening, the letterman brought unto me a little gilt-edged invitation saying, "Gilhooly, come over to tea." Sure, I knew that the Houligan sent it. So I went just for old friendship's sake, and the first thing they gave me to tackle was a piece of Miss Houligan's cake. There was plums and prunes and cherries and citron and raisins and cinnamon too. There was nutmeg, cloves, and berries, and the crust, it was nailed on with glue. There was caraway seeds in abundance. Sure, 'twould build up a fine stomach ache. 'Twould kill a man twice after eating a slice of Miss Houligan's Christmas cake. Miss Mulligan wanted to taste it, but really there wasn't no use. They worked at it for over an hour, and they couldn't get none of it loose. Till Houligan went for the hatchet, and Killy came in with the saw. The cake was enough by the powers to paralyze any man's jaw. Miss Houligan, proud as a peacock, kept smiling and blinking away till she fell over Flanagan's brogans and spilled a whole brewing of tay. "Oh, Gilhooly," she cried, "you're not aiding. Try a little bit more for my sake." "No, Miss Houligan," says I, "but I like the rest of that cake." Maloney was took with a colic. McNulty complained of his head. McFadden lay down on the sofa and swore that he wished he was dead. Miss Daly fell down in hysterics, and there she did wiggle and shake, while every man swore he was poisoned through eating Miss Houligan's cake.
Thank you.
The darkest midnight in December, no snow nor hail nor winter storm shall hinder us for to remember the babe that on this night was born. With shepherds, we are come to see this lovely infant's glorious charms. Born of a maid, as the prophet said, the God of love in Mary's arms. Ye blessed angels, join our voices, let your gilded wings beat fluttering o'er, while every soul set free rejoices, and everyone now must adore. We'll sing and pray that he always may good people one and all defend. God grant us grace in all our days, a merry Christmas and a happy end.
Thank you. Thank you.
The bells of waiting Advent ring. The tortoise stove is lit again, and lamp oil light across the night has caught the streaks of winter rain in many a stained glass window sheen from Crimson Lake to Hooker's Green. The holly in the windy hedge and round the manor house, the yew will soon be stripped to deck the ledge, the altar, font, and arch and pew, so that villagers can say, "The church looks nice on Christmas Day." Provincial public houses blaze and corporation tram cars clang. On lighted tenements I gaze where paper decorations hang. And bunting in the red town hall says, "Merry Christmas to you all." And London shops on Christmas Eve are strung with silver bells and flowers, as hurrying clerks the cities leave to pigeon-hunted classic towers. And marbled clouds go scudding by the many-steepled London sky. And girls in slacks remember Dad, and oafish louts remember Mum, and sleepless children's hearts are glad. And Christmas morning bells say, "Come," even to the shining ones who swell safe in the Dorchester Hotel. And is it true? And is it true? The most tremendous tale of all, seen in a stained glass window's hue, a baby in an ox's stall, the maker of the skies and sea become a child on earth for me. And is it true? For if it is, no loving fingers tying strings around those tissued fripperies, the sweet and silly Christmas things, bath salts and inexpensive scent and hideous tie so kindly meant. No love that in a family dwells, no caroling in frosty air, nor all the steeple shaking bells can with this single truth compare, that God was man in Palestine and lives today in bread and wine.
Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree, oh,
I am your friend, and my love for you goes deep. There is nothing I can give you which you have not got, but there is much, very much, that while I cannot give it, you can take. No heaven can come to us unless our hearts find rest in today. Take heaven. No peace lies in the future which is not hidden in this present little instant. Take peace. The gloom of the world is but a shadow. Behind it, yet within our reach, is joy. There is radiance and glory in the darkness, could we but see. And to see, we only have to look. I beseech you to look. Life is so generous a giver, but we, judging its gifts by the covering, cast them away as ugly or heavy or hard. Remove the covering, and you will find beneath it a living splendor, woven in love by wisdom with power. Welcome it. Grasp it. Touch the angel's hand that brings it to you. Everything we call a trial, a sorrow, or a duty, believe me, that angel's hand is there, and the gift is there, and the wonder of an overshadowing presence. Our joys, too, be not content with them as joys. They, too, conceal diviner gifts. Life is so full of meaning and purpose, so full of beauty beneath its covering, that you will find earth but cloaks your heaven. Courage, then, to claim it, that is all. But courage you have, and the knowledge that we are all pilgrims together, wending through unknown country, home. And so at this time I greet you, not quite as the world sends greetings, but with profound esteem, and with the prayer that for you, now and forever, the day breaks and the shadows flee away.